The experiment that you're about to see is one of the first things that inspired me to want to become a physicist. I think it perfectly captures some of the awe, wonder, and mystery surrounding trying to figure out what the world is made of. To try and capture some of that reaction that I had, I asked my friends who hadn't seen the experiment before and who are not physicists to have a look, and here's what they thought.
Okay, I have no idea what the double-slit experiment is or who Dr. Quantum is, but I'm excited to find out.
I feel like this is a Fine Brothers audition.
This will be interesting. Let's give this a go.
Just want to specify that I know nothing about quantum physics. I did watch a bit of Bill Nye the Science Guy as a kid, so I'm hoping that works a bit in my favor, but I'm still more than 100% sure this is going to make me question everything. So let's get started.
And here we are. The granddaddy of all quantum weirdness. The infamous double-slit experiment.
I mean, just look at the man. Look at his hairstyle.
To understand this experiment, we first need to see how particles, or little balls of matter, act. If we randomly shoot a small object,
marble machine,
say a marble, at the screen, we see a pattern on the back wall where they went through the slit and hit.
Okay, so far pretty simple, pretty easy to keep up with, but something tells me it's going to get a bit more complicated than that.
Now, if we add a second slit, we would expect to see a second band duplicated to the right.
Yes, I would expect to see a second band.
Okay, once again, still fairly simple, fairly logical.
Now, let's look at waves. The waves hit the slit and radiate out, striking the back wall with the most intensity directly in line with the slit. The line of brightness on the back screen shows that intensity. This is similar to the line the marbles make.
Okay, so 3 for 3 so far. So far, everything's fairly logical. Let's hope it stays like this.
Okay, waves and marbles making the same sort of thing.
But when we add the second slit.
Oh no, I feel like something's gonna happen when there's two slits.
Something different happens. If the top of one wave meets the bottom of another wave, they cancel each other out. So now there is an interference pattern on the back wall. Places where the two tops meet are the highest intensity, the bright lines, and where they cancel, there is nothing.
Not gonna lie, that's actually pretty cool.
Okay, so that one's a bit more complicated, but it still makes sense. Okay, so far we're coping, we're keeping track. Hopefully that stays the same.
So, when we throw things, that is matter, through two slits, we get this. Two bands of hits. And with waves, we get an interference pattern of many bands.
So is this like the difference between waves and particles and all that?
Good so far. Now, let's go quantum.
Oh, quantum.
Uh-oh, we're going quantum.
I just can't stop laughing at him.
An electron is a tiny, tiny bit of matter. Like a tiny marble.
Are electrons matter? The real question is, do electrons matter?
Let's fire a stream through one slit.
It's amazing what they could do these days.
Okay, this is when I think, I just a small feeling that things are going to get a bit more complicated than the first few experiments.
It behaves just like the marble, a single band. So, if we shoot these tiny bits through two slits, we should get, like the marbles, two bands. What? An interference pattern!
Where do these interferences keep coming from?
Oh god, there's always an interference with this guy, isn't there?
Okay, so this is the point of the video where, to me, this makes no sense. You've lost me at this point. I'm trying to make sense of this experiment. The only way I can wrap my head around it is if the marbles, the electrons, aren't matter, but oh man, I'm hoping at the end of this video they tell us how this is possible. I hope they give us a logical explanation and not leave us in the dark.
We fired electrons. tiny bits of matter through. But we get a pattern like waves, not like little marbles. How? How could pieces of matter create an interference pattern like a wave?
Yeah, I don't know how. I'd like to know.
So it starts as matter, then becomes a wave, and interferes with itself?
I feel like I'm watching a cold case for science.
It doesn't make sense. But physicists are clever. They thought, maybe those little balls are bouncing off each other and creating that pattern. So they decide to shoot electrons through one at a time. There is no way they could interfere with each other. But after an hour of this, the same interference pattern is seen to emerge. The conclusion is inescapable.
What?
The single electron leaves as a particle, becomes a wave of potentials, goes through both slits, and interferes with itself to hit the wall like a particle.
What? Okay, let's just keep going.
But mathematically, it's even stranger. It goes through both slits, and it goes through neither. And it goes through just one, and it goes through just the other. All of these possibilities are in superposition with each other.
It goes through both and neither. Yeah, that makes sense.
The fact that he's laughing in the background of his own video is just that I wouldn't trust this guy to deal with my quantum theories.
Physicists were completely baffled by this.
I'm baffled by this.
So they decided to peek and see which slit it actually goes through.
Okay, so now I'm hoping they find out how this is possible. This is the point where I'm hoping they give us a logical explanation.
They put a measuring device by one slit to see which one it went through and let it fly. But the quantum world is far more mysterious than they could have imagined. When they observed, the electron went back to behaving like a little marble. It produced a pattern of two bands, not an interference pattern of many. The very act of measuring or observing which slit it went through meant it only went through one, not both.
How does someone make sense of this? How are you meant to make sense of this?
The electron decided to act differently. As though it was aware it was being watched. And
what?
And it was here that physicists stepped forever into the strange never world of quantum events.
Oh, I like the conspiracy music.
What is matter? Marbles or waves? And waves of what? And what does an observer have to do with any of this? The observer collapsed the wave function simply by observing.
That is by far the most mind-bending video I've ever seen by a long shot. And the worst part is that there's no answer at the end of this video. They just give us the dilemma. I don't even know how this is possible. I'm just trying to comprehend what I just watched.
I personally don't know what to think about this, because how did that happen? How did it split? How did it go through both slits but also neither? That's just, first of all, that's a mind blow. But then the second mind blow is that when it was being watched, it was like, oh, pranked, I'm gonna do something different. What?
And that was definitely trippy. That was something that didn't make sense in the physical world. I don't know, like matter or waves? Well, maybe it's something else. Like maybe it's not either or.
I actually thought that was actually pretty good. I feel like nobody can relate when your hairstyle looks like that.